Con Steve Carrigan. Steve tiene una particularidad y es que la red social para buscar trabajo o para mover la hoja de vida por excelencia es LinkedIn. Pues este señor era el maestro en talento humano y fue vicepresidente de LinkedIn justamente. Yo creo que sabe una que otra cosita, va a estar en el foro Liderando en Tiempos de Incertidumbre que organiza la Asociación Colombiana de Contact Centers y BPO junto a ACDEC. Y es un espacio que es interesante para entender cómo se lidera y cómo se manejan los recursos humanos cuando hay una generación de millennials que viene con unos valores tan distintos a las que estábamos acostumbrados en generaciones anteriores. Esto va a ser en el Country Club el próximo 29 de octubre y lo tenemos en la línea. Steve, good evening, welcome. Thank you for being with us in La Nube, sir.
Thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here.
La primera pregunta es, como les digo, ¿cómo hace uno para liderar el talento humano, para motivar cuando los millennials vienen con un chip tan distinto y con un ejercicio de vida tan absolutamente particular? Steve, a lot of talent is young talent, and millennials come with a complete different set of mind. How do you manage to, how can you motivate, how can you work on human talent when you have such a specific circumstance that is completely opposite to what we were used to in previous generations?
I think the best way that I've seen to approach this new millennial talent is to recognize that I think today the talent is looking for more of an adventure than a career or a job specifically. And to appeal to this generation, the best way to do that is to, if you're trying to hire them, is to tell your story about why your company has lots of exciting adventures. And why your company is a place where they could grow and learn and develop new things. Because clearly, I think their desires, as you point out, are different than prior generations. And they have a lot more information today to make choices about where they're going to work or what company they want to be a part of. And I do think that this generation cares more about the culture. They want to work for companies that are doing good in the world. So it is a very different dynamic, I think, to address this new population, for sure.
Es una dinámica, sin lugar a dudas, distinta, nos dice Steve. Dice, los millennials, más que un trabajo, están buscando una aventura. Usted tiene que venderles el reto. Antes todo el mundo quería quedarse en una compañía y usted era el que tenía que pelear por quedarse en la empresa. Ahora es usted el que tiene que retener ese talento. Y dice una cosa que es muy interesante. Dice, mire, las generaciones anteriores querían mantener el trabajo, crecer en él, ir avanzando, ir progresando, ir ascendiendo. Aquí no, esta es gente que está más interesada en hacer el bien que en tener plata. Entonces, motívelos, capitalice esto.
Yo definitivamente no pertenezco a ese grupo.
y se adapte su mensaje de cara a esto.
Diego, le podemos preguntar, ya aprovechando pues que ha tenido muchísimo que ver con LinkedIn, y es normalmente los usuarios, nosotros, los empleados, ¿no? Usamos LinkedIn para poner nuestra hoja de vida, para poner allí nuestra experiencia, para conectarnos con otros profesionales, pero ¿hasta qué punto las organizaciones se están metiendo en esta dinámica, las empresas, y están usando LinkedIn como un ejercicio profesional?
LinkedIn is usually used by employers or by natural people just to seek jobs or to move a certain curriculum vitae and so forth. But enterprises, companies are getting more and more into the activity of working LinkedIn as a social network. Being the head of human talent for the VP for human talent at LinkedIn, how much would you say that this is catching on to big companies?
You know, that's a really great question, and I think we're starting to see that it is starting to get more traction in the enterprise because people see that there are things to learn beyond just recruiting. There are ways for you to find people that have expert experience that maybe you want to understand, or you want to bring someone into your company just to share their ideas rather than just hire them. Or you can find very interesting articles and research that applies for you and your job specifically. And this, I think, is the area of intelligence that organizations are starting to see, that it's not just a place to find people, it's a place to find ideas, it's a place to find inspiration, and also to find people that may be interested in your product that you're selling, not just a job opportunity, but there's ways with the internet today and with social networks, I think, for us to have a much more intelligence around what someone cares about and what someone's interested in. And I think it's a marketing dream to have all this new information. But to your point, I think enterprises are waking up to many different uses, such as understanding customers better and understanding where they can find better information to make them smarter and more effective as a business.
All right, I'm the translator. Pues mire, primero lo felicita por una gran pregunta y dice, mire, el ejercicio es, las marcas están empezando a despertar y están empezando a entender que las redes sociales, particularmente LinkedIn, pero en general las redes sociales, son un sueño para cualquier marketero. Dice, son un sueño porque le permiten entender mejor su consumidor, entender mejor sus necesidades, aproximarse de una manera más adecuada a ese consumidor. Y a ese consumidor que puede ser, el valga la redundancia, el consumidor final o su empleado, vuelve y juega con el tema de véndales un ejercicio, véndales un sueño, véndales que su compañía, y véndales no en el sentido malo, sí, sino en el sentido de aproveche para contarles que su compañía tiene un propósito, que hay una misión, que hay un ejercicio que viene detrás de esto. Y en ese orden de ideas es ahí donde está la gran oportunidad de las compañías, no solo con LinkedIn, particularmente con LinkedIn, pero en general con todas las redes sociales.
Hablando de eso, dice que las empresas están en un despertar. ¿Cómo hacer para que las empresas entiendan ya que las redes sociales y el internet hacen parte del mundo, que los puede ayudar y no que son diversión,
una distracción?
Exacto.
You talk about an awakening. Which is the most effective way to get enterprises or companies to understand that social networks are not just a distraction, but rather than that, an opportunity, as you point out? Which are the best tips to get management to understand such an opportunity?
I think the best way to get management, to get leadership in enterprises today to understand the real valuable insights that you can find for your business through social networks like a LinkedIn or social channels like a Twitter or a Facebook, for example, is to start to bring up the concept of what I call professional brand. And this is a concept which I think is gaining very significant awareness around the world and is very relevant for managers, because people, employees, customers are talking about companies more than ever before in many new ways that many people can see. And it's very important for leaders in an organization to recognize that and to recognize they have an opportunity to tell their story about how great they are as a company to work for, how great they are as leaders to be effective. And this is a new market space, I think, to be able to tell your story beyond the traditional print media or radio media or television media. Now we have a new distribution channel where I think leaders have to be very active so that they can tell their story about how good they are as an organization or how good they are as leaders. And I think that is just a reality that organizations have to recognize, that the conversations and the information flow is going to different channels, just the same way as newspapers have taken a huge hit in terms of readership over the years, that people's eyeballs are spending more time looking at different things and listening in different ways than they have before. And the more organizations can recognize that there's actually ways that you can play offense and help your organization not just play defense and react, this is why I think there's a big benefit in capability for leaders to help their organizations if they are active in these new channels.
Well, thank you so much for being with us, Steve. Our listeners will be looking forward to meeting you at the Country Club in Bogota next October 29th. Thank you so much, sir. We appreciate you being with us.
Thank you very much for having me. Take care.
Bueno, pues mire, vuelve y juega con el tema de contar la historia y dice, las compañías tienen que entender que de la misma manera que los periódicos o los impresos en general han recibido el golpe de que la lecturabilidad se ha afectado porque han migrado a otro tipo de formatos de consumo de información, lo mismo pasa con la información organizacional, con la información institucional. Y los que no entiendan que esto es una nueva manera de contar una historia más allá de los medios tradicionales, se van a quedar atrás, tienen la oportunidad.